Before we look at the chemical reactions in the family of amines, we need to see the nitrogen that is carrying an unshared pair of electrons will act as a Lewis base. What that means is that this lone pair of electrons in the presence of water can make a covalent bond with this hydrogen, forming ammonium hydroxide. What we say is that now we have a brand new covalent bond between nitrogen and the hydrogen. Nitrogen will have four bonds and it will be associated between an anion from the hydroxide and the cation from the nitrogen, making what is called ammonium hydroxide. Ammonia is a gas. When we place the gas, we bubble the gas of ammonia in water, is making ammonium hydroxide, and the pH of the solution should be a basic pH. Since amines are considered derivatives of the molecule of ammonia, they will also carry a set of lone pairs of electrons. The same association with the molecule of water will take place. In the first case, we have methyl amine, set of lone pairs making a brand new covalent bond with the hydrogen, making methyl ammonium hydroxide. And on the second example, this is now a secondary amine, also in association with the molecule of water. What we see here is an increase in the number of hydrogens bonded to the nitrogen. We started with NH2, now we have three hydrogens. In this one, we only have one hydrogen, and on the second example, the end product has two hydrogens bonded, making a covalent bond with the nitrogen. One of the hydrogens is coming from the molecule of water. This is another example of the interaction between a tertiary amine with the molecule of water. In this case, we also have the formation of four bonds around this nitrogen, and this one will be the trimethyl ammonium hydroxide. We have introduced hydrogen bonding in the chapter of alcohols, and this was a molecule of alcohol oriented probably to a second molecule of alcohol. We describe a hydrogen bond as a hydrogen that is partially positively charged, sharing this charge with two electronegative atoms. In this case, we have an amine, which is oriented towards a hydrogen bond donor. It could be a molecule of water. So we have the hydrogen again between two electronegative atoms. And the amine can also be providing the hydrogen for the hydrogen bonding. So that is a hydrogen that will be electropositive because it's bonded to a nitrogen, very electronegative atom. And then the hydrogen has to be between these two electronegative atoms. For the hydrogen bond to be strong, it has to be with the three atoms within the same line and a small distance between them, no more than 2.5 angstroms. And this can also exist when we have a carbon-oxygen double bond and an oxygen that will be the hydrogen bond donor. These type of interactions are extremely important in the biochemistry part when we discuss the protein folding, and not only that, but also DNA structure. We can represent the hydrogen bond between amines and water in two different ways. This is a primary amine, is attached to only one carbon, and the nitrogen set of lone pairs is the hydrogen bond acceptor. We reoriented the molecule, and then the nitrogen-hydrogen is the hydrogen bond donor, making also a hydrogen bond with the molecule of water. In the case of the secondary amine, we can have a hydrogen bond donor with the molecule of water, or this set of lone pair can also be interacting with a second molecule of water. In the case of a tertiary amine, we can only have a hydrogen bond acceptor where we have the nitrogen, because it has no hydrogens to be working as hydrogen bond donor. Amines can also make hydrogen bonds with themselves. Primary and secondary amines will have a set of lone pairs that can act as a hydrogen bond acceptor,
And they also have a hydrogen bonded to the nitrogen, which is an electronegative atom that can work as a hydrogen bond donor. For that reason, small amines will have boiling points much, much higher than alkanes because they can make hydrogen bonds with themselves. So when you look at this ability, is only limited to primary and secondary amines. When it comes to a tertiary amine, they do not make hydrogen bonds with themselves because they do not have a hydrogen bond donor. There is no hydrogen bonded to the tertiary amine.